This is Honda Africa Twin. In the late 80s, with the boom of the Paris-Dakar rally, motorcycle manufacturers decided to bet on a new category of bikes. And this is how adventure tourist bikes were born. The Africa Twin, also known as Hixarvi 750 or 650, is one of the most legendary adventure touring bikes. Production started in 1988 with the 650 model and ended in 2003. Some may argue that the 650 model is the better, smaller version of the Africa. It all depends on what you are after. In the 650 was lighter and more off-road ready. The 750 is heavier and feels better on gravel and tarmac. Recently, the Africa name was reborn with the CRF 1000L model and became one of the most popular adventure bikes again. But enough about history. Let's talk specs and then I will tell you why I decided to sell my beloved Africa. The bike is equipped with 750 twin motor, producing 62 horsepower and around 60 Nm of torque. Top speed is 174 km per hour or 108 miles per hour. It has a 5-speed manual transmission with wet clutch. It takes 4.7 seconds to launch this 240 kilos from 0 to 100. Or in imperial units, these are around 500 pounds from 0 to 60. The time is the same. Motion to the rear wheel is transferred by chain. The tank is 24 liters or 6.1 gallons. There are no luxuries on board. You get all the 90s bike standard stuff. No adjustment, no adjusted seat, no auto-canceling turn signals, no gear indicator, fog lights or whatever modern adventure bikes have. But why I bought this bike in the first place? I needed something reliable that will survive Bulgaria's country roads. My first bike was Kawasaki Ninja 250. It was a great bike for beginners, but it broke too much. I never knew if it was gonna start or if it's gonna take me to my destination. So my search ended with the Africa. It's one of the most reliable bikes out there. It was descendant of the Dakar rally bikes, so it had to be tough. And it is. In my 10 years of riding this bike, only once it let me stranded. And it was because of electrical problem. My alternator failed and didn't want to charge the battery. So I stopped for a break and when I tried to start the Africa, I had no juice. And the problem with this is that I was on a level road. I couldn't push start it even with the help of some passers-by. Finally we jump started and I safely got home. This failure is seen very often because of the loose connectors in the wiring. They tend to break the regulator rectifier and sometimes even the alternator. Since then, I replaced all the connectors on the bike and I had no troubles. Another major issue with the bike is the fuel pump. It tends to fail around 60,000 km. My odometer shows 62,000 and so far so good. For maintenance is all the usual stuff. Carburetor adjustments from time to time, oil and filter changes. I once replaced the chain and the pinions, tires, cooling fluid. They say that valve adjustments have to be done regularly, but when I went to a mechanic to do that, he opened the head and said that they are fine and do not need to be adjusted. Still, I think I should do that because sometimes when idling the engine stops, especially if it's cold. Also when the bike is not used in 2 or 3 weeks and I try to start it, it starts only on one cylinder and after a few seconds the second one jumps in. And then the magic starts. When the bike is up and running, it drives like a huge battleship. I've never driven a battleship, but this is what I imagine. The riding position is tall. You are high above the skies and it's heavy. It turns with heaviness and power. It grunts and jumps like an African lion. On the road, it can be pushed hard. 160 km per hour is not a problem for cruising speed. If you have the guts to stand the wind and hold it straight. I don't know if it's my bike or our Africas are like that, but the V2 engine has a lot of vibrations in certain RPM. I've noticed that in 5th gear, around 110 km per hour, the bike is really smooth. Go above that and its handlebars start to have some noticeable vibration. That goes away if I have my wife riding in the back and the bike is loaded for travel. Then it's all smooth again. A lot of people ride these bikes on long trips, but if you want to do that with your Africa and your butt is not made of iron, then you should get a different seat. The stock seat is awful. It's hard. It's not ergonomic at all. Maybe it was softer when the bike was new. I don't know. The good part is that you can start up and ride tall. I do that very often, and if I have my wife in the back seat, I tell her to massage my boot to allow some blood flow. When you are up on the highway with this bike, you don't want to stop. And you don't need to. If you ride responsibly, you can get up to 350 km from one tank. The engine is very responsive and has a lot of torque, so for quick overtakes you rarely need to shift down and rev up. The front wheel is 21 inches with narrow tire that's great for driving in rain. It just breaks the pedals and holds the bike very stable. The riding position is very comfortable and upright, but this bike is not meant for heavy off-roading. It's just too clumsy and top heavy. The high center of gravity makes it very hard to control in low speed. It takes real skill to ride this bike in the woods or on some rough terrain. I've done this several times, and each one of them I was terrified. After all, if you fall on and the bike lays on your leg, you are pretty much in trouble. I don't know many people that can lift 240 kilos from the ground, especially if you are laying and one of your limbs is below the bike. Another big problem for me is the height of the seat. I am 175 centimeters or around 5.6 feet and I am not short, but I am not tall either. When I am sitting on the bike and I drop my legs down, only my toes touch the ground. There were several times that I just dropped the bike on the ground because it was very top heavy. However, when you start riding on the road, you forget all of this. Yep, I like this bike. It's reliable, it has a character. It's not comfortable or convenient. It's not economical either. It can drink as much as 6 liters per 100 kilometers, especially if you have a passenger and ride faster than 120. But when you pull that throttle, there is this angry grunt from the engine, like you just awoken the lion and he saw an antelope. So, this is all. I like this bike a lot, but I need something new and different. I've set my eye on a Honda Pacific Coast. What can I tell you? I like rare bikes. Now, let's have one last look at the Africa. And if you like this video, you know, the usual stuff. So, thanks for watching and drive responsibly. Someone's life depends on you.